In 1989, an American psychologist named Francine Shapiro was walking in the park when she first noticed her eyes making spontaneous saccadic movements towards the upper right when she was thinking disturbing thoughts. She proposed that these saccadic eye movements were linked to the alterations in information processing that she perceived within her mind and led to what is now known as EMDR, or eye movement desensitization and reprocessing therapy. In early EMDR treatments, Shapiro intentionally reproduced these saccadic eye movements, with patients instructed to shift their gaze back and forth between two fingers held up in front of the patient on either side of the midline or with extremely rapid contralateral movements. Saccades are rapid ballistic movements that abruptly change the eye's point of fixation. These movements can differ in amplitude, ranging from smaller movements like the ones you make when reading a book to larger movements like the ones made when you look around the room. This form of therapy is often used to treat post-traumatic stress disorder and complex post-traumatic stress disorder, also known as PTSD or CPTSD. You may be thinking, what's the point and why does it help? Well, the repetitive redirecting of attention in EMDR induces a neurobiological state like that of REM sleep. REM sleep, or rapid eye movement sleep, plays an important role in dreaming, memory, and emotional processing. This REM state is optimal to support the integration of memories into general semantic networks.
We have two types of memory networks, episodic and semantic. The semantic memory focuses more on factual and conceptual knowledge about the world, mostly through language. The episodic memory focuses on one's life events that the person has experienced throughout the phases of their life. When we perceive an event in our conscious awareness, the initial formation of the episodic memory occurs in the hippocampus, and our brain extracts and stores the emotional information of the event in our amygdala. The integration of the episodic and semantic memories is facilitated by REM sleep. This emotional processing, however, which again happens in REM sleep, fails in people with PTSD. During an EMDR session, the current procedure is to ask the patient to recall a distressing part of the traumatic event that they wish to work through. The therapist helps the patient focus on the visual representation of the trauma most strongly associated with negative feelings and distress. The patient then gives a negative self statement they feel because of that event. For example, these statements could be, I'm helpless, I'm weak, I can't take care of myself, or I'm not good enough. The patient also identifies the effect evoked by the image in their head, whether it be fear, anger, sadness, or something else. The patient rates its intensity from 0 to 10 on the subjective units of distress scale, which is commonly used in exposure therapy, where individuals estimate the severity of their fear in a situation, with 0 being no fear and 10 being the most severe fear and distress that they've ever experienced. At the same time, the therapist helps the patient become aware of, and describe in detail, physical sensations and thoughts that arise when thinking about these images. Together, the therapist and the patient also establish a direction to the therapy by developing a positive cognition. This answers the question, when you see yourself in that situation, what would you rather believe about yourself than the negative self-statement that you just mentioned? The patient is asked to rate the degree to which they believe this statement at a gut level. Together with the distress rating, this assessment helps the therapist gauge the progress towards a more emotionally improved interpretation of the traumatic event. Following this initial phase, however, patients then hold the image, their thoughts, feelings, and physical sensations in mind, and move their eyes back and forth by following the therapist's hand. These sets of alternating stimulation last from 20 seconds to several minutes, depending on the patient's emotional reaction. The patient's emotional reaction is associated and correlated with physiological signs of relaxation, such as reduction of blood pressure and heart rate. After each pause, the patient reports on what came to mind. This may be a new image, thought, emotion, or at times, a change in physical sensation. The patient then focuses on this new information and another set of stimulations via eye movements follow. The process continues until the associations are no longer changing or until only positive associations and sensations are reported. Depending on the remaining level of distress and strength of the positive cognition, the therapist may then decide to initiate further processing of the initial image or to start processing other aspects of the trauma. Patients often express new beliefs about the traumatic event, such as, "It wasn't my fault," with a puzzled expression on their face, or with a smile of relief. Or they find themselves almost disbelievingly accepting a painful past mistake that has haunted them for decades, using statements like, "I really didn't have any other choice at the time," or "I did the best I could under the circumstances." In between eye movement sets, patients engage in normal conversation with the therapist, typically reporting on what occurred during the stimulation. They do not appear to be in a trance state. They typically describe their flow of consciousness during eye movements as resembling focused daydreaming. EMDR has been shown in several controlled studies to reduce PTSD symptoms to the level of non-patient controls, and the results of EMDR were seen in 3 sessions or less for more than 80% of patients, with a dropout rate of less than 10% and no noticeable side effects. Amazingly, controlled trials of EMDR for civilian PTSD report 77 to 90% remission rate. Thanks to a walk in the park, the Psychological Association's Committee on Verified Treatments now proclaims EMDR as efficacious for civilian PTSD, and multiple randomized controlled trials have supported the efficacy of brief EMDR treatments to reduce PTSD in most victims of adult onset trauma. Future research should assess the impact of lengthier intervention, combination treatments of EMDR and medications like antidepressants, and treatments on the resolution of PTSD in adults with childhood-related traumas. For more videos like this one, please visit the Demystifying Medicine McMaster YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.